If you guys are looking for the best dribble moves in NBA 2K21, you guys have found the right video for you. I'm a play shot, and I consider myself one of the better dribblers in the game, and I like to just get myself open. I don't like to do all the flashy stuff, but enough of that. Now let's get right into it.
Chill feeling so sad, I had a double load of racks. If the fuck call up my phone, I gotta go, I'm moving fast. Dripping in some Nike lubes and I got Gucci on my ass. Bitches used to call me dirty, now I wipe my ass with cash. I was always on the first, I used to stress about the bag. Thinking daily about this money, swear it making me go mad. But they treated me the worst, so I don't.
Yo, what's good YouTube? It's your boy Carson Got Fans, aka Always Carson, and today y'all, I'm gonna be putting you guys on to the best dribble moves to use in NBA 2K21. If you guys want to be able to sauce like this, or just be able to score the rock in general, this is the video for you guys. You guys are gonna watch the whole video through. I'm gonna be putting every dribble move that I have. Sorry, I didn't put all of them last time. I think I skipped like size up, escape, and all that, but I got y'all this time. I've changed my moves, I think maybe two or three things. But before we get into today's video, I want y'all to put in the comments, who do you guys have for the finals? Do you guys have the Heat or the Lakers? Personally, I think the Lakers are going to win, but I wanted to see the Heat win. Just Tyler Herro's like a bucket, and Jimmy Butler, all of them are great players. So I would love to see them win and not LeBron for once, but y'all let me know down in the comments. But now we can get right into the dribble moves. All right, y'all, first off, we got quick dribble style and then pro 2 crossover. And the main reason I use pro 2 crossover is for this specific reason, to get this long kind of cross. You know, it's like if you play 2K15, you guys know what I'm talking about. You get like this long, just glitchy kind of crossover. And the reason I like it is because imagine there's a screen to my left. I use it, man goes behind me. That's for an easy crab and then an easy shot. And that's the main reason I use pro 2. And then quick, you obviously want to use if you're a guard, because it's the quickest, obviously. Now we can move on to the other ones. All right, now moving on to behind the back pro 4 and basic one spin. The reason I use basic one spin, you guys should know, the little spin back cheese that you can always do if you get like a good, I can't really do it too good this year. As you can see, I do it right there, but I can't do it that consistently. And then just the behind the back, because I feel like it just gets you a lot of space. Like, even though it's not the fast one, it's just this one, I feel like it gets you like some distance enough, like off a screen. Like that's what I'm saying. Like, I use screens a lot when I play, so these moves fit me the best, just because I use screens most of the time. I'm not like a straight ISO comp, you know, guard, anything like that. This is personally what I use, and that's why I think this behind the back is so good. All right, now moving on to two of the probably most important things on this list. My signature size up and my pro hesitation. My pro hesitation, I use pro 2, and my signature size up is Curry. And this is the whole reason I use signature size up Curry, so I can do the little Curry slide like this. And then the hesitation, things that people don't really do, like, let's be honest, like, we don't usually do these hesitations like too much, but with this pro 2 hesitation, you can get a little bit of a speed boost out of it, as you can see right here, and you're just gone like that. And like I said, if you're using a screen like I do usually, it'll help you out a ton. And then the signature size up is Curry, because like I said, once again, if you have a screen, you can be doing this, get him to run to the screen, go the other way, easy screen every time. All right, moving on for park size up, I do not have one because I hate park handles how it is already, and I don't want to start rolling on the ground even more and do like a roly-poly or anything like that. I really just don't like it at all. Moving on to basic size up, I have pro 5, and to do that, you just want to hold up on your right stick and your character will do it right there. Moving on to size up escape, all you want to do is hold up on your right stick and pull down on your left stick. So you do like a kind of escape move, as you see right there. And I have like, there's a bunch that you can, your character can do. You can do that one, you can do, if you go this way down, you can go to the right, to the left, anything like that. That's the escape. And then I do not have a triple threat style, but I put it in there just in case people are like, oh, why don't you show us? That's a secret. But yeah, I do not run a triple threat style either. But now I can show you some clips and how to use them in games. All right, now moving on to gameplay. Like I said, y'all, these dribble moves may not be for you specifically, but if you're a guard that just likes to use screens, so there's two types of guards that I like to consider. There's an IQ guard, then there's an ISO guard. IQ guards are ones who are like, you know, use screens. They know the game of basketball and that's what they play by. And ISO guards are the people that know how to just like do the glitchy moonwalks and all that. And I consider myself like a IQ guard. As you can see, I do the Curry slide to the fast behind the back. And if you guys want to know how to do the misdirection behind the back, all you have to do is, you don't even have to hold RT, you just go diagonal down with the right stick to your off ball hand and point the left stick in the direction you want to go. And that's how you do the misdirection behind the back. It's really simple. And that's one thing I like about these moves, that you can kind of chain them together, some kind of Mortal Kombat style, and chain it all together. Because every guard is trying to do the fast behind the back. That's like their game plan. Like, that's what you want to do. That's the move that gets you open. So anything that can get people like in a different way and then hit that behind the back and make them go flying the other way to get open is basically what you want to do. So let's say you do like the Curry slide, and then you do the misdirection behind the back, the Pro 2 crossover, and you crab them and you green it. Like, that's going to be a tough combo. You know, I can just see it in my head, because I've been using these dribble moves since like the game came out, I'm pretty sure. I think I've only changed maybe the signature size up, but that hasn't really changed too much, because once I learned the Curry slide, it was pretty much over from that point on. Another really good thing about these moves is that they can either be used in the rec center or park, prime, anything. I feel like they can just be used anywhere because they're not too flashy if you know what you're doing with them. Like, the Curry slide doesn't get ripped too much, but the thing I'd recommend to watch out for, I highly, highly, highly recommend to watch out for, is those bump steals by those locks. If they're on your hip, you just got to be careful. Try not to just go up the corner and do it behind the back every time, because people pick up on that. I pick up on that, and I'm a guard. That's how I get most of my bump steals. People come up, do a crossover, and they do it every single time. So I go ahead and get on their other side, get the bump steal, and take it up for a layup. So be careful with that. But that's why I think these dribble moves are so clutch, because they can work in pro-am or just any kind of play, rec, park, anything. All right, you guys, that is going to wrap up today's video. These are the best dribble moves in NBA 2K21. Simple as that. They work for me, and if I can dribble with them, I know you guys can. You guys are probably better at this game than I am, not going to lie. Like, I mean, I enjoy it, but after this recent patch, it's been kind of bugging. I don't know. It's like I had more fun at the beginning of 20, but anyway, that is going to wrap up today's video. Like I said, I hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, make sure you guys smash that like button for me. It helps me out a ton, and I'm going to be leaving a playlist in the description for all the best builds and all, like, my best jump shots and all that. I have just a playlist of, like, how to get better at 2K21 and all that. For all the newer people at the game that are just trying to get better and stuff. And I'm also going to be leaving my Twitch in the description as well, because I'm going to start streaming up there a lot more, because I'm almost an affiliate up there. So if you guys wouldn't mind, I drop a follow up there too. It would mean a ton to me, and it helps me out a ton as well. But that is going to wrap up today's video, y'all. I love you all. Peace.